What's that D stand for?
Hello, everybody. Card Dreamer here, coming at you on behalf of D-Class and all things D-Class related. And today, I'm bringing you a Let's Try for an indie title called Icey on the Nintendo Switch. That's right, another Nintendo Switch title. I'm just amazed myself sometimes. But anyway, it just looked interesting. It was on sale, really pretty cheap. So I figured, why the heck not? Let's give it a shot. Okay, we get different moves we can upgrade. I love the graphics. I think visually those are really nice. Certainly like the finishers. That's pretty cool looking. Music is pretty solid. Controls are nice. I mean, they're smooth. Nice. Oh, there's a dash. Okay. Oh, it would have been nice to know that all the other times they appeared. There is a double jump. Do anything. So, we'll leave that alone for now. Look at that background. That's pretty. I like this. Oh, she broke my shield. Oh! Trinity's chains. cheap shot. What? Great, I'm glitched. Try this icy bin again. That was cool. Oh, that's just creepy. Did I take off the mask? What? I don't want easy mode. That's how you determine it? Alright, well, for the sake of the let's try, we're gonna keep going, but. Yeah, no, actually, we're gonna reset, because I don't do easy. That was cool, chaining that together. Nice, getting the hang of this. No, I know I don't have enough. I only got 38. So it's cool to get the hang of this, actually. Wow, I am getting my butt handed to me. Yeah, take that. No. There we go. All right, so. See what happens if I say yes. Oh, no! I don't want hard mode! What the flip? Alright, we'll just... Interesting.
In the middle of a dark, quiet room, filled only by the sounds of humming machines, a figure floats, suspended. She, Icey, has no memories, no past. Memories to her are not important. Her existence only serves one purpose, to kill Judas.
Oh, that's creepy.
That wicked devil, the bringer of the apocalypse. No matter how many difficulties or obstacles she will face, Icey understands that she must accomplish her mission. Destroy Judas. In the darkness, Icey awakes. Icey has left the laboratory. She understands.
I'm not thrilled with the narrator.
As long as she follows the arrow, she will discover where Judas is hiding. Oh, more soldiers sent by Judas to stop Icey. Kill them.
Still, I love the visuals of the game.
Icey reaches a quiet hill, illuminated by light dancing off of the lake below. She is at peace.
That's cool that you can kind of chain them like that together.
There seems to be a console that Icey.
Whoa!
Icey is absolutely positive that the only way to cross the ravine is by activating the photon bridge.
So you're gonna activate? There we go. Can't argue that. That's a lot of fun to pull off.
A disgusting swamp rests, unmoving, in front of Icey. She must carefully jump across.
Now I can actually afford them. There's a nice variety of attacks to do. That's cool.
Icey arrives in the moonlight forest. In front of her waits Daha. Wait, where's the bridge? Right. Just keep following the arrow. Icey jumps down. It seems like this is an old sewer.
Oh, man. Nice.
This place is littered with wreckage. Icey feels that this place wasn't always a sewer. And who is to blame? Judas. Icey jumps down into a giant cavern.
That's the one thing that's kind of turning me off on the game is this narrator, because he's not good. Not horrible, but I mean, he's just bland. And...
Icey
But I can overlook it, because I am, like, loving the art style for this game.
Icey follows the arrow through and passes through the gate. Icey senses that the key to her escape is somewhere in front of her.
Okay, calm down. Ow. Okay, this is not good.
Icey discovers a special treasure chest.
Ooh, a special treasure chest. Oh, I have to hit it. Okay.
A strange mark flashes across her eyes. Icey's dash ability has grown stronger. She can probably even escape from this damned underground labyrinth.
Okay, that's pretty cool.
Immediately return to.
You received a message. Press A to accept the message. Attempting to find the chosen one is as difficult as finding a needle in a haystack. My time is limited. Judas has tampered with the necro thingy. I can't even talk. Necronomicon, and declared his intent to sacrifice his physical body. Yeah, okay, you put the sewer message over. Okay, got it. That's a pretty cool thing. I like the way the dash is working. I mean, I like that it's like you're not limited to just a double dash or something. It's pretty cool that you can kind of now open up the world in all these different directions.
What could cleanse this place?
I want to sacrifice XP right now, or health right now, HP. You know what? I will keep some I will keep some money. Because money does not seem to come all that. Oh, crap. Gorgia. Ow, ow, ow. Really? Really? I am not even getting a chance to hit. I'm about to die. Yeah, oh, I did die. Holy crap. Yeah, there wasn't anything I could do on that one. And I gotta keep in mind, this is on hard, even though I didn't one hard. Really? Wait a minute, I pushed A and he dashed, or she dashed. Well, I went right into that, didn't I? What the heck? Like, I just drop. Come on, hit. Come on. Okay, I try to zoom out of there as soon as I can, but... The problem is, really? There's stupid little floating things with the lasers. Like, taking them out is a pain. See, that little laser, I feel like, should not have hurt me the way it did. And I'm trying to dash away from when that explanation comes up, and it didn't do it. And there's I have like no warning. There we go. We're getting a better rhythm now. Why is she not moving? Sheesh! Come on. I'm trying to... It's like they know when you're trying to move. Sheesh. See? How did they know? How did he know? And why can I not? Wow, this is tough. I'll get this though. I will get this. Come on. That was weird. Like, see how much damage that's doing? That is insane. Now, see, I jumped and somehow I still got caught in the arms. Where'd he go? Oh. I have no control over that. Nice. See, I can't drop down so I can actually get it. There we go. I think we're getting the hang of this. Well, I was until that. What? I had a little bit of health left. Don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. Huh. Let's see what happens if I upgrade my damage a little bit. See if it gives me the edge that I need. I did not tell you to jump down. I wanted to dash away. There we go. We did some damage. Really? I jumped up the hit and I'd somehow end up. Yay. That was cool. It's a matter of just hanging back long enough to get your shield back at least. And well, that doesn't help that somehow I magically ended up in there. Oh my gosh. We did it! Woohoo! And there are achievements. That's actually, well, yeah, they put in their own achievements. That's pretty cool.
Icey defeats Gorgor and senses that the exit is just ahead. Icey arrives at an unnamed town. There is not a soul in sight.
Are we saved?
Icey searches around the house for a trace of someone, a mark of some presence. It seems as if everyone has been wiped out. Icey decides to head deeper into town, not hesitating to follow.
I kind of want to save there. So, guys, we're going to call it an end there. I thought this was a fun game. It was a little challenging, but I'm also playing on hard mode, so that was bound to happen. Anyway, I'm Card Dreamer D-Class. Leave your comments down below what you think of this game, if it's one you're going to pick up. It's actually pretty cheap on sale right now, at the time of me recording this anyway. And I don't think it was that much to begin with. I think this is actually a good game worth getting for the money. But yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe. And until next time, stay evil.